So Jonathan, I'm excited, but a little bit nervous about you doing your own HVAC. We've never done it on this old house, but I thought we would start here at the Southface Institute. This was a place started in the late 70s, sort of a think tank in that post-energy crisis we had back then to teach building professionals. So we're going to use it today to help teach you.
Great.
So Jonathan, say hello to Amelia Godfrey.
Hi.
So take us through Southface.
Welcome to Southface. We are a Atlanta-based nonprofit. Our mission is to promote and support resource-efficient and high-performance building design, construction, and maintenance. So welcome to our office.
Thank you. Nice to be here. You guys have a lot of stuff going on here.
We do. We believe it's very important for us to practice what we preach. Over here is our rain barrel for collecting gray water to flush our toilets.
Right.
And then back here are solar panels that provide electricity for our office. This right here is our training classroom.
Look at this, like a candy store.
It is our favorite room in the whole building. It's where we teach people about building science. We've got little training cabins to demonstrate mock-ups.
Air in and out. And
air leakage. HVAC. We've got residential water heaters and furnaces that we use to help show people how these types of systems work. And this is our training cabin.
Great.
Where we find that we have the greatest impact with education when people are actually able to experience how houses work.
All right, Jonathan, does this look pretty typical around these parts?
Yeah, very much so.
All right, this is your standard duct installation. You got the central location here and all of it goes this way. So what they did is they have the typical installation right here and it becomes an opportunity to teach how you might improve upon it. If you notice right here, you get insulation in the ceiling of the second floor. And then there's an uninsulated roof. Now that means what? How hot does it get in your attic?
At least 120.
Okay, so 120 degree ebb. So that sun's beating down. This is trying to cool the air. And in every off cycle, it just sort of superheats the ductwork. So I always recommend insulating here. And the best way to understand it, if you were trying to stay warm on a cold day, would you wear just a scarf? Or would you wear a hat? And the hat's the difference.
Definitely a hat.
Okay. The other thing up here you can notice is the ductwork. Looks like the HVAC guy got here first. Took the path of least resistance, just ran these straps anywhere they wanted to. Everywhere there's a chance for impingement. But the other thing that catches my eye is someday, the owner's probably gonna want some luggage upstairs here. And when they do, what's gonna happen? They're gonna go like this, they're gonna kink it more or break it, and all of a sudden the whole place is out of balance. So I imagine, you know, you and Keisha might want some storage upstairs.
We definitely do.
Okay. So when you do your duct work, really think about the utility, okay?
That makes a lot of sense.
All right. Good. Are you ready to go?
Well, thank you, Richard. I think there's a lot of lessons to be learned up here.
You're on your way.
Thanks for watching. This old house has got a video for just about every home improvement project, so be sure to check out the others. And if you like what you see, click on the subscribe button to make sure that you get our newest videos right in your feed.